Hi friends, this video is part of the Back to Basics card hop organized by Courtney at Handmade Happiness Facebook group. Today we are coming together to show you projects made with minimal supplies and basic techniques. Let's begin. I have a sheet of Canson watercolor paper that I taped down with painter's tape to a hard board, and I'll be using watercolors to create backgrounds for two cards. My idea is to create gradient of blue color, dark on the top and fading to almost white at the bottom. First thing I do is wetting the paper, even tilting it so I can see if everything is covered. And now I'm adding a light wash of the blue. I'm using a round brush, but a big flat brush would be perfect. And actually I will change to that in a bit. So what I'm doing here is mainly adding the color on the top and spreading it downwards, but not going all the way down. I'm moving the color side to side till somewhere around the middle, and then I just continue with water only, and I will repeat this many times until I'm happy. And I think most of the time I'll be having my hardboard upwards. Now I'm fast drying my panel, and I will repeat the process with a bit more concentrated color, and again starting on the top and having horizontal brush strokes. Once I apply color, then I dip my brush in the water, then I pick some more of the pigment, and I continue till I reach under halfway, and then I add just water, and I will dry my panel again before applying even more dark color. The cards that I'll be showing you today are really simple, and I'm sure everyone can do something similar. And this is how I started, or I should say what made me decide to start card making. I'm not gonna go in more details, but around 3 years ago, I decided to make a little bit more advanced Christmas cards. We usually make them with my daughter, and back then she was 5 when I bought watercolors for her, so we can create this kind of night skies. Back to the card here, I need a darker shade of blue, but I don't have in this watercolor set, so I mixed the blue with black and a dab of purple to create this color, which resembles chipped sapphire distress ink. And I will do what I have been doing so far. So, as I said, I bought the watercolors, some mixed media paper, and stickers, glittery stickers that you will see a little bit later in the video. And unfortunately, I have no pictures to show you these cards, what we made, just because back then taking pictures wasn't a thing. But anyway, it's something really easy, and I'm sure everyone can do it. So once I'm done, I sprinkle a little bit of salt from the kitchen here and there to create a little bit more textured effect. And here is how it looks. I think I sprinkled way too much on the top, or maybe my panel wasn't wet enough. I don't know, but it didn't really look like what I wanted it to be. But there is an easy fix. But before that, I will sprinkle a little bit of perfect pearls mixed with water. This is completely optional. You don't need to do this if you don't have the perfect pearls. And here I will set the panel aside to dry. And once it's dry, I actually went one more time with my blue color. So now it's more smooth and perfect porous spread. So the whole background is shimmery. And here I'm taking the painter's tape off. I got a little bit of tearing, but I will be trimming this down anyway. And here I will split it in half and cut the wide border. So this is the advanced card, a little bit more advanced. With a small brush, I'm going to make some first one vertical line and then some scribbles with diluted black color just to resemble some kind of trees. And I'm having the wrong brush, which I will change a little bit later in the video. So it's a little bit harder to paint with this, but I think you're getting the idea. It's just some scribbles like zigzags, but the key point is to leave some space between these lines just so it's more airy and it doesn't look like some big blob. And the further the trees are, the lighter I'll be making them, so they're like faded and nothing has to be perfect anyway. So I will add a few more trees once these dry, and even go back and add a little bit more color, more concentrated color on some areas. Here I'm taking a little bit from the blue color and I'm creating some snow banks at the bottom or at the base of these trees. And once the others are dry, I will add a few more in the open spaces so it looks more like a forest. I will set it aside to dry. And here I will add even more color. And this time with the small round brush, I just go over the existing ones and it really looks like a scribbling. This is how it looks. From this Lawn Fawns stamp set, I took the Santa with the reindeers and I'm stamping it with Versafine Onyx black ink. And the first card is almost ready. It only needs white splatters for falling snow. Any kind of white paint, acrylic paint would work. I just happen to have the gloss spray, so I covered the Santa and the reindeers and I'm just generously splattering, and I got this big white droplet onto the Santa, but I will fix this at the end, so nothing to worry about. And now off to the easiest card. I have this glitter paper. I have also die cut sentiment Merry Christmas, once from white cardstock and one from the glittery. So I cut some piece out of the glittery paper before adhering it to my card base, just because I can use it for another project. And these are the glittery stickers that I bought almost 3 years ago. I have still some left, and these snowflakes are just perfect. They even match the glitter paper. So first I will adhere the sentiment down somewhere at the center, and after that I will start adding the snowflakes around it. Some will be off the edges and I will trim the excess off with my scissors, but just to make sure everything stays adhered well, I will add just a little dab of glue behind each sticker. Here I'm adhering the watercolored panel onto the card base, just making sure it's straight, even though it's not completely straight, but no one will notice, hopefully. For the other card, I did almost quite the same, just I used some dark blue marker to cover the piece of cardstock, and here is everything ready. Oh no, I'm adding a star with white jelly roll pen and a little bit more snow. And here I just took a black pen and I'm covering the part of that white droplet that I don't want to be white. So thank you for stopping by and check the next person on the hop. I have the link down in my description box below.